Hi everyone, my name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to show you how you can create a Twitter animation in just using the tool PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. Also, just to let you guys know, this video idea actually came from a fellow subscriber you'll see right here. So if you guys do have more suggested videos and topics of what you guys want me to cover, make sure to leave those in the comments down below. So to see what this actual effect looks like, I'll play it in presentation mode first, and then I'll break it down piece by piece on how you can actually create this yourself. Also, if you want to follow along during this tutorial, I actually have a link to the template in the description below, so make sure to look out for that. So if I go into presentation mode, you'll see that the Twitter logo appears, and then birds fly out, then they fly back in, and then your Twitter handle can appear. Now it's super fast, so I'll play it again. It bounces a little bit, and it's just a nice, smooth, quick thing. I didn't want to make it too long, because usually people, when they're looking at this animation, they're not going to want to spend a bunch of time on it. So it's a nice, quick thing, kind of smooth. I haven't seen really anything like this out there, because I created this from scratch just using PowerPoint. So I'm going to show you guys how you can add this to your videos, or even if you just want this to put on Twitter, whatever it may be. Also, please note that the background for this scenario is going to be the Twitter color, but if you do want it to be a green screen color, all you have to do is change the background color to be a lime green color, and then you're good to go to add it to any of your videos. Alright, so with that in mind, let's break down piece by piece on how I actually made this. So if you're going to see on the right here, there's actually a bunch of different animations here, so I don't want you guys to be too overwhelmed by this because a lot of them are pretty repetitive and doing the same type of effect for multiple objects. So we're going to start here in slide 2. All I did was I went on Google, looked for a Twitter logo, and particularly an SVG icon. And the reason why I focus on getting an icon that's SVG specific is because you can scale this icon to any size or decrease it, and it won't lose its quality. So that's the beauty of SVG files. So now once I have this icon in here, I also added in this text called Follow Me. And for this text, I actually used the font Latto Heavy. And you can get this Latto font if you just search Google Fonts Latto, and then you can download all the different type of Latto fonts and add them to your deck as well. And then I had a font size of 54. Next, what I did was I just had to animate these two objects. So to animate this bird, all I did was go to animation, and I went here to add animation, and I added a fade animation, and then I also added a line animation right here. All right, so once I clicked on both of those, and I'll show you right here exactly what I did. So I'll remove these two, go here, click on the object, add animation, fade, add animation, line. So then once those two are added, you just have to play around with the timing. So for the fade part of this animation, I had a duration of 0.5 seconds and then a delay of 0.25 seconds. And then for the line animation, I had a duration of 1.75 seconds and a delay of 0 seconds. Now you're going to want to make sure for the line animation that you actually adjust these arrows. So let's say I have this object right here. I remove these animations and I add line animation. You're going to see that has a default length right here. You're going to want to just click on this green dot, hold down shift, and you can change how far or short this animation goes and travels. So the green dot means that's where it's going to start, and the red dot shows where it's going to finish. Usually I like to have the red dot finish where the icon's originally placed, but you can do either or. It doesn't really matter. Just depends on what you prefer. So for this case, I have the icon starting up here, and then it's going to flow in to the bottom right here and land where this icon originally is placed. And the reason why I have a delay of 0.25 seconds for the fade animation is because I want that object to be already moving before it appears on the screen, so it's a nice fluid motion. So now once I have that animation all set for this Twitter bird icon, then I can actually apply the same effect to the Follow Me. So I'll show you how you can do that. So I'm just going to copy this text right here, and let's say I don't have that effect yet, and basically what I want is I want this same animation to be applied to this text. So what you do is you click on the object that's already animated, click on Animation Painter, then click on the text you want to have the same animation, and now the beautiful part is that this animation is the same as this one up here. So I'm just going to delete this because we don't need it, a second one. And then another thing, and we'll get into this later, but eventually that's going to actually float out and it's going to show your actual Twitter name. So that's why I have a float out exiting animation right here. So another thing that I forgot to mention earlier is that for this line animation, you're going to want to click on both of these and go into effect options and have a smooth start of 0.88 seconds and then a bounce end of 1.43 seconds. That way it slowly comes in as like a smooth entrance, and it also does a little bit of a bounce to just kind of give it a little bit of flair when you're doing this animation. It's not needed, but I like to do that just to make the animation look a little nicer. So now, and those are basically for the follow me, it's the exact same as the Twitter bird with the same delays and links. And then to add this flow out, all you have to do is click on this text, go to add animation and click on float out. And you're gonna wanna make sure that it's a duration of 0.5 seconds and a delay of 1.75 seconds. All right, so now we can put this in presentation mode, and that's what it looks like every time I play it. So now if we wanna jazz it up a little bit more, we can move on to slide three. So I have here all these birds right here, and I also have them on the right as well. So what I did to create these birds, all I did was take this large one, copy and paste it, make sure the animation is removed, and then hold down Control Shift and click on a corner, and you can just drag it. So that's a way you can scale the icon perfectly. And that's what I did to just make them the sizes of this. And let's say you want to copy this icon, you can just hold down Control and then click and drag, and that's how you can make more than one copy of it. You can also obviously right click, copy, and then paste. But I just like to do Control because it's just quicker. And obviously all these are a bunch of different sizes, so you're just gonna have to make these smaller. And I also rotated them a bit just to make it look like it's a flock of birds flying. And then all I did was is copy and paste. Once I finished this set of birds, I copy and pasted them, and I went to Format, Rotate, Flip Horizontal, and that's how you can get your other side of the birds as well. Obviously you can position them however you would like, but this is how I position for this video. And now as I go into presentation mode, you'll see that they're kind of flying away and then they come back. So I'm going to show you guys how I add that animation. So I clicked on this, I first added a fade because I want to enter the screen. And then what you can do is you can hit custom path, and it gives you these perpendicular lines. Click in the center of that image and drag, and you're kind of drawing the path that you want this bird to take. And I just had it go off the screen. So once you're done with where you want it to go, make sure to hit escape, and that will end the path of the animation. So basically that's all I did for all of these. I made custom paths for all of them. So let's say, here, I'll just show you guys for two of these. I'll pretend that we're having them fly up here. This is exactly what I did. Clicked on it, fade, add animation, custom path, hit escape. I also make sure that these are always with previous, because that way you can decide how you want to time these. And I always have the fade part of this animation a little after the actual line starts moving. That way the bird's already moving before it appears. All right, so that is how I made that animation for all these birds. And so then in terms of timing, so we have this bird pop up and we also have this follow me text pop up. These are popping up at the same time, but for these birds, what I want them to do is, I want them to all start at a delay of 0.5 seconds and then go for 0.75 seconds. So that's how long it's gonna fade in. But then for the actual motion of the line, this is how long it's gonna be. It's gonna be 1.5 seconds and delay of zero. And then what I also did, because as you can see, they go out of the screen, but then they come back. So you need to click on all these you can just click on one and then hold down Shift and then click at the last one. Hit this drop down arrow, hit Effect Options, and then you can do a smooth start of 1.5 seconds. And then also make sure you check mark this auto reverse. That way, whatever the animation does, it'll just rewind the animation and go back to where it was. So that's how I got the birds to go back to originally where they were placed. So this is a delay again of zero and a duration of 1.5 seconds. And then that is how, when we go into presentation mode, we get those birds fly out and then they come back in. The last part of this is just putting in your name of your Twitter account. So I have here your Twitter handle, Mine is, if you guys really want to follow it, is tstans15. I don't really use Twitter, but if for some reason you do want to follow me on Twitter, feel free. All right, so that is where you would put your Twitter handle. And what I had to do for this one is a very similar animation to this, but just slightly different. So I made sure to add a fade animation, and then I also added a line animation, and I'll show you guys right here exactly how I did that. So I'll copy this and then I'll remove it. So I went here and make sure you're always choosing this drop down arrow right here, otherwise you can't add more than one animation to it. So I did a fade and then I did a line animation, and for this case I actually want the animation going upward. All right, so that is how you can add those two animations to the actual text. But then in terms of timing, what I did was for the fade animation, I have a duration of 0.5 seconds. So that's how long it's going to take to come in. And then it also has a delay of 2 seconds because I want this animation to happen first and then this one to happen slightly after that animation comes in. For the line part of this animation, I have a duration of 2 seconds and a delay of 1.25 seconds. And then once you are all set with this, feel free to line it right over the top of your other text, because it's not gonna look all jumbled like that when you're actually playing it. Because if you remembered from before, we have this float out animation that happens right after this animation enters, which is the follow me text. And it's gonna float out as the Twitter handle floats in. So it looks really nice and smooth. All right, so now we can go into presentation mode to see the full effect. All right, so the bird pops up, follow me, the birds come back in, and then your Twitter handle pops up at the end. So it's a nice, simple, quick animation. Again, if you are wanting to make this a green screen for your video, you can always right click format background, go here to solid fill, and then you can pick a color, go to more colors, and pick on like simple green screen. And there you go. That is how you can have a green screen for your video. Now, in terms of this background, all I did to get these colors was look up what the Twitter company's common colors were for their logo. So that's how I got these three colors, and then I just made it a gradient. And this one's just, it's zero transparency and positioned at 100%. This one's positioned at 71%, and again, transparency zero. And then this last color is positioned at 17%. All right, so that is how you can make that animation. Now for the last steps of actually exporting it as a video, what you need to do is you need to make sure that all these slides are deleted except for the slide with the entire animation on it. So I'm gonna delete these real quick. And then what you need to do is you need to go to File, Export, Create a Video. You can choose whether or not you want in 4K or just 1080p. Honestly, either or works. I always just do 1080p just to make it easy. All right, so based on how long the animation is, we'll determine how long this needs to be. So if we go back here to this animation, we will see that the last part ends at around 3 seconds. So just to be safe, I would probably do 4 seconds. That way you have a little bit of buffer room just in case anything does go a little past 3 seconds. And then all you have to do is hit create video, choose where you want it to be located on your computer, and then you can add it to your videos or whatever else it may be that you'd like to use this for. So I hope you guys found this tutorial helpful on how to make an animated Twitter pop-up kind of call out for your handle. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I actually have a course on Udemy. I'll have the link to that in the description below so you can check out that. And as a thank you for making it this far in the video, there's gonna be actually a discount for that link, so make sure to look out for that in the description. Lastly, let me know what you guys are looking for next in these types of PowerPoint videos. I love to take PowerPoint a step further, so I'd love to hear what you guys are kind of looking for next. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.